Hello, this is Habibur Rahman. Welcome to my channel. Now today I am going to teach you how to run C or C++ code in Sublime Text. So firstly, you have to install the Sublime Text in your operating system. That is, if you are using Windows, you need to install the Sublime Text for Windows. If you are using Linux, then you have to install the Sublime Text for Linux. So I will give the link in the video below, and you can follow the link to install Sublime Text in your operating system. So I have installed the Sublime Text in my operating system. So here it is. Basically, I'm going to show you how to run a C or C++ code in Sublime Text. And the input will be, so the input for your code will be taken from a file, and the output also will be taken will be printed in a file. So that's why it will be very efficient for a programming contest and other purposes. So please join with me and see how to do it. That to compile C++ code, there is a support in C Sublime Text already given, but if you want to run, if you want to take the input from a file and print the output from a file, you have to do something special. That's why this video is going to be recorded. So here is a here is a C or C++ code in my Sublime Text, and I have three columns in my Sublime Text window. One is for input, it is in input.txt file. It's in the same directory, it's in the same directory where my I am writing the code. You can see I am writing a code in a directory named competitive programming, where the input and output files are also in the same directory. So here is the code. So you can separate your Sublime Text window into three columns, from view and then layout. You can find the columns. Okay, so for my code, the input is given here and the output is printed here. So firstly, you need to add a package for this. You can add it from the project. So you can add it from the tool option and build system. After under this, you have to add a new build system. So here in new build system, you will have to put the JSON code to run for compilation. So I have the JSON code here. So here is the JSON code. Also, you can find it here. Here is the JSON code that I am going to paste in that C++ Sublime build. So I will give you it in the link below. You can find it from here. So here is the timeout. The time needs to run the program if the if I have set it here 4 seconds for timeout in my compilation process running time. So if it's greater than 4 seconds, then it will be exited automatically. Here is the input file name, and that is from which file I am going to take the inputs, or my code is going to take the input, and the output.txt is the output file that my code is going to print the outputs in that file. So I will give you please follow the link in the video description to pin to get this JSON file. So after that, pasting the JSON file here, you can change with your your own interest that is the file name and the input file name and output file name of your own choice. It can be text file, it can be a binary file, or it can be other files. Okay, so that's not a big problem. After pasting here, please save it, and it will be saved in that directory, that is that's the username and .config Sublime Text version. It can be Sublime Text 2, Sublime Text 3, packages, users. Under this, it will have it will be saved. So please change it by your own the name, that is C++, as we are going to save as we are going to add this packages for C++, please add C++ dot sublime dot happen build. Okay, so after saving after save you, as I have saved it earlier in my system, so I'm not going to save here. After that you can press, you have to press Ctrl B, that is compile, it will compile. And so here is the input file. I'm going to show you how it works. So if I have pressed Ctrl B, then it started running, and it shows here the NIST in 2.2 second and output that that you are going to please remind that output is printed in that output file, and it is shown in output.txt. okay, so this is the very basic and very interesting feature of Sublime Text to run C or C++ coded codes, where you will get the input from input file and paste the outputs in output file. So bye bye for today, see you next.